This is Susan Bradley for CSO Online. Today I'm going to talk about VPN security. During this time of work from home, you're probably using quite a bit of VPN technologies. The attackers are going after that VPN technology as well. They know that you're needing that more than ever, and they're going after it too. First and foremost, make sure that you're patching and using up-to-date VPN software. Make sure your firewall, if that's what you're going through, is also up-to-date. Earlier this year, USCert noted that attackers were using vulnerable Pulse VPN software to attack and drop ransomware on the networks. The vulnerability was a worst-case scenario. It was a remote, unauthenticated attacker that was able to compromise a vulnerable VPN server. The attacker was then able to gain access to all active users and cull out their plain text credentials. It could even be possible for the attacker to execute arbitrary commands on the VPN clients. Thus, the attacker was able to get complete access to the network by scanning for and finding vulnerable VPN servers. The only way to protect your network in this situation was to apply the available patches. Even if you don't have systems that are vulnerable, it's wise to go back and review your VPN connections to see they are as secure as they can be. Remember to review your settings to ensure the maximization of management systems. Early this year on CSO Online, I discussed the issue of split-tunnel VPN and the use of Office 365. As I said at the time, for many years the best practice was to tunnel all traffic for the network through the VPN tunnel. But with so many people remoting in from home, and with Office 365 and click-to-run patching technologies, it's now recommended to split the traffic. Have management and updating go through their local user's connection while the rest of the traffic needed for the office work is directed over the VPN. If you use always-on VPN provided by Microsoft and you have Windows 10 Enterprise Edition 1709 or later, with the client device join the domain, you can set up device tunnel feature. This allows computers to establish an always-on VPN connection prior to the user logging on. This will allow you to let users cache credentials without concern and risk. This is important especially with these days, with so many new users remoting in from home who are logging into the devices for the first time remotely. Some of you are setting up laptops and delivering these systems remotely without people coming into the office for training and setup. The device tunnel is also key for remote support as it allows administrators to manage remotely connected always-on VPN clients without having a user logged on. Finally, the device tunnel can assist with user issues that are caused by self-service password reset, or SSPR. But as I said earlier, with so many of us using VPN for remote technologies, it's time to review this. Recently, the National Security Agency released two documents regarding securing VPN. The first is called Securing IPsec Virtual Private Networks and discusses the regular tasks you should do. For example, reduce the VPN gateway attack surface. Verify that cryptographic algorithms are compliant. Avoid using the default VPN settings. Remove any unused or non-compliant cryptography suites. And apply vendor-provided updates for VPN gateways and clients. If you can, set up strict traffic filtering to limit the ports, protocols, and IP addresses of network traffic to VPN devices. If you can't filter to a specific IP address, and clearly at this time, it's very hard to do that, ensure that you have your firewall set not to just open the port for VPN, but to provide inspection and monitoring for IPsec traffic and inspect IPsec session negotiations. Next, check your cryptographic settings and make sure the suites you're using are the most secure they can be. If you use out-of-date settings, attackers can both breach the connection and also breach that confidentiality and lose the credentials information. So you can review the current IPsec SAs by reviewing the ones in use. Check your vendor firewall documentation. I've included some for Cisco, but you'll need to check with your normal firewall vendor. The second document put out by the National Security Agency is more detailed as to configuring IPsec virtual private networks. Again, they talk about the bare minimums and go into a little more details with specific vendor recommendations. And once again, I can't stress this enough to apply vendor-provided updates. It's so key to make sure that you have up-to-date software on your VPN clients and gateways. It's disheartening to see when a vendor releases a security update for their product. In this case, the Pulse VPN software was out in April of 2019. And in August, there was already 14,500 vulnerable VPN servers still unpatched. In January 2020, cyber criminals targeted unpatched VPN servers to install ransomware. And again, think of how damaging this was. A remote, unauthenticated attacker was able to compromise a vulnerable VPN server and get into the network and provide ransomware to everyone in the network. You don't want to be there. You don't want to do that. So make sure that you review your VPN software, your settings, don't take the defaults, and find this video and more on the IDG Tech Talk out on YouTube. Until next time, this is Susan Bradley for CSO Online.